Hey guys, what's up? It's Kaz Hamid here. How are you guys doing today? And I know I haven't recorded much, and that's gonna change because I can record now because I have times. So guys, this is gonna be a guide video. I haven't done one of these in a while, and this is going to be Endgame, how to kill what I like to call the most annoying boss in the game. So first things first, we got our things set up right. Oh, I swear to God, if another wave comes, I'm not re-recording that, yo. Screw it, Lego. Kill you. Alright, so basically, you assume that, right? And it pumps harps. Harpies are trying to kill me. Okay, turn down the volume. And okay, there you go. So, harpies will come and try to kill you when you're not paying attention. Anyway, I have this set up, so it is 20% chance not to consume ammo, which is good because we're going to be using the Unreal SDMG. If you do not have this gun, then I recommend using the Vortex Beater, I believe it's called. It's a really good gun, I think it's a piggy bank right here. Boom, Unreal Vortex Beater. And the reason why, obviously, this gun is not going to compare to this gun. It's damage, but boom, there you go. We're going to be using that because, obviously, you have to kill this guy to get the Unreal SDMG. Now here, I've been farming him. Bought. Yeah. So the Moon Lord, obviously, is doing. So I'll get back to you when he's about to summon and talk some more. I use that because it increases the max number. Obviously, that's just crafting things. Done. So without further ado, let's go piss off some cultists, and I'll be back with you. This come and try to murder us. Yeah. By the way, before we start to piss them off, just so you guys know that nothing here you don't need to kill the Moon Lord to get any of this stuff. I mean, obviously solar flare armor is pretty good, and you will need that, but in order to farm the solar, whatever the hell they're called, because I don't remember, whatever you need to farm them, you can actually, before he comes, or it says, you know, goes all dark, save and quit, and then rejoin, and he won't spawn, but you'll still have all the stuff. So that's how I farmed this armor. Obviously, if you have any questions, you can check out my achievement run videos, which will be down there. It shows me starting from the bottom, getting all the stuff that I need for all this stuff. So let's piss off some cultists. And by the way, I will be using the Vortex Beater with normal ammo, just endless musket pouch, because it's actually one of the most useful items in the game if you are looking for a ranged gun build. So anyway, I'll talk to you guys when he's about to try and kill me. Oh yes, you are annoying. Come on, hurry up. Okay, freaking stuff to do. Now the reason I'm using the Vortex Beater and I'm using it actually does have a homing projectile that fired. So definitely good. So this, you can take a look. Armor of the Myths, good. Well, obviously that much. Charm of Myths just helps. Okay, to be perfectly honest with you, it helps with regen. Definitely something that you're gonna. Do I have any potions on me? I got a reskin. Why am I recording this entire thing? Guide video, and I show you guides. I don't know what I just said. Alright, so I'm gonna stop recording now before I die. Kill us again for like the thing. Quick little tip, I just finished beating up the friggin' guys that drop vortex fragments. That. What was I gonna say? Look out for the hearts that they drop. Obviously, you know, by now, if you're this end game, you know that enemies drop hearts when you kill them. You will definitely want to pick those up because a vast the majority of the farm, that's how it's powered. those hearts to recycling. So that's what you're going to need. So you might want to pick them up, because I have run into issues before where I didn't pick any up. Then I went fun for anybody, especially me. I didn't pick up any hearts, so the heart generator was like, listen, there's a max number of hearts allowed in a world, and you've already exceeded that, so go away. So that's definitely an issue, and you guys should definitely keep your eyes open. I don't know if they fixed this from happening, but it has happened before. Obviously, at sound, you know that we're in the next area, so I'll talk to you guys later. So this is actually what I'm talking about here with the hearts over there. And there are a couple of other hearts as well that you should be looking for. You know, here's one. Yeah. And now, I'm just before the storm, and we gotta get moving. Oh, obviously you have to go back to wherever you set this up. And yeah, so I decided to set it up in the middle of nowhere so that no one will get hurt. And obviously we have these running. Not good. So we're gonna switch so we have chlorophyte armor now, obviously. So we'll be safe. Kind of, I hope. By the way, this isn't a glitch. If this is your first time, I don't recommend this being your first time if you just did it. But if this is your first time, this screen going crazy type thing is not... Don't worry about it. It's really nothing to worry about. It's just a boss about to come. Yeah. Obviously, chlorophyte ammo works amazingly well. Oh, I hate you, Waver. So, yeah, just gotta ping down his arms. Basically, I'm going to be quiet, and that death ray can't hit us, which is among some of the better, definitely, definitely useful part of this whole kinda area type a deal. One thing I don't like is how high it is up above the ground, so it's a little bit harder, obviously, to... get peace and quiet. We obviously, with all the enemies that are gonna come and annoy you, like these friggin' harpies, but luckily harpies only have, I think, only 100 health, so it's definitely not something that you need to worry about. Definitely though, if you do get the SDMG, which is one of the best ranged weapons, in my opinion it's the best because I like fully auto and I just point in their general direction and they're dead. That's how I play. Obviously the tactical shotgun from 1.2.4, which used to be my best, ranged weapon, because it had 4 or 6, something like that, chlorophyte bullets every time you shot one, and only consumed one ammo, so that was definitely good in 1.2.4, obviously health potions help, and, oh, normal health potions help too, just, so you know, you're dead. Obviously, we have this eye now. This is going to decide to be annoying. Really annoying. Sometimes you have to drop down. Unless you have the heart magnet type thing. I don't know what it's called, but there's one thing that helps your hearts can be obtained from farther distance. I don't know. I have no idea how it's supposed to be. But that's that. And I don't know what it's called, and if I do know what it's called, at the end of this video, I will show you, or I'll at least talk about it, but I don't think I have it. Remember, I had it once, but I don't know what happened. Now, obviously, endgame gear is definitely going to be your best bet to beat this guy. I've not seen anybody do it on the first night. I remember there used to be a couple of YouTubers that would do it on, like, first night challenges where they beat the skeleton... Skeletron Prime, I don't know what it's called, but the guy you go the old man for and beat him in the first night. I've seen people do Eater of Worlds in the first night. That was one thing that I did, in fact, try to do, but a lot harder than it's cut out to be. A lot harder than people make it look. Yeah, we're just going to melt this guy down, and his final form, if you pay attention, down right below me, there's a blue oval with a line down the middle. That is where you're going to be aiming. Right there, where you're going to be aiming after this is done. So just wait for him to open his eye and just pump, hit him down a couple times. It will take some time. I don't recommend the Mega Shark for this. I know that the Mega Shark could be a little bit better than the Unreal Vortex Beater. In a couple ways, like ammo conservation. That really shouldn't be a problem with your ammo box that obviously I have set up. Definitely is a very good thing to have handy. And you can get it from the Traveling Merchant. It comes every so often. And it is really hard sometimes for me to remember to go to the Traveling Merchant, especially since I'm usually exploring. When the Traveling Merchant comes, I don't just sit around and farm him. You obviously could, but I don't know, because you could not go AFK, because it's really sporadic as to how often he comes to your village. Yeah, so you have to be careful, and one thing is that the exploration can wait. He does not. It would be a lot better, though, if he could settle down. But it would be a lot harder to program. Because I don't know how that would work, right? You have to figure out for him the way to cycle through his stuff. So I guess shop timers would be a thing then. Just ideas. Ideas in a farm, guys. This is what this channel is about. Well, it was about. Then I started Let's Plays, and then not as fun. So, you know. Obviously. Now the farm. You're almost dead. I blow up. Really? Oh, I thought you... The true eye of Cthulhu. Wasting ammo. Dead. Die. Please die. Yeah, there you go. And now we aim down and game's over now. So obviously you can use a couple different weapons. For example, the Solar Flare, which is number 3 in my hotbar right now, is definitely a good weapon to use. With this farm, you have to use a weapon that can hit through walls, because a big thing, the survivability, is being able to survive those blasts. As you can see, those eyes are definitely going ham. So we can actually switch, and this thing just chews up health. As you can see, the health bar is going down so fast. Another thing is the Lunar Flare, definitely overpowered, but you also need a Magician build, or a wizard build, or a magic build. Also, guys, pay attention to your health. I know that I haven't been, because I went really low. You have to pay attention to your health, because that is the main thing. That's how you know you're going to live. Now, every time you beat him, you will always get a portal gun, and then you also get another different weapon. I do have the portal gun on me. Obviously, because, it's good. Lunar Staff summons turrets. Celebration. This gun is actually really good. Gun, sword, oh god. And then this just fires Nyan Cats. Oblivion. The last prism, I think, is by far the most badass weapon. Obviously, because... just look at this. It's just amazing. I think you should definitely have it. You don't need all this decoration, all this decorative stuff. It's not something you need. Jesus, souls, bro. Quick stack that. That, obviously, free some room up. Now, Lumite is definitely good because you can, build stuffs with it. Obviously, you have a Lumite bar that you make. And once you make the Lumite bar, and you go boom, and Lumite bullets, arrows, and a couple other things that are definitely good. I really like the Lumite bullets. I didn't think I was going to, but then I actually used them, and then... they were actually really OP. yeah, that's the end of this episode, guys. If you guys liked it, please leave a like. Ask me any questions down in the description below. I read all the comments, so I will definitely see your comment. I'll try my best as well to respond to them. It's a little hard sometimes, though. You guys have to understand that. A lot of other things going on right now. Ugh, and I'm not saying that to be like, justify me not reading comments. It's just something that happens. If I see your comment, I read it. Just, I'll try my best to respond to it as soon as it happens. Sure. So, yeah. That's the end of this episode, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Before I go, though, here is the basic okay, I'm gonna get out of the way. Yeah, you definitely get a lot of coins as well, farming. A lot of stuff. Alright, so, show you the basic construction. There's cloud. I don't know if those are cloud or bubble. Whatever they are, that's what I used. Really basic construction. Alright, okay, so it's bubble. I don't know how to make. I don't know how you make bubble. But, I will make a guide on that. Enough. I use honey because the honey is life regeneration is increased. Have you, which is the campfire, like slightly increased for regen. And then I also have lanterns, which is heart lantern, which is also increased on life regen. Now, when I use this set, and I know you could probably argue that you could use either of the three real endgame sets. Personally, I prefer the melee armor because it has the highest defense, which is typically what I want in a build, is survivability. So, I will go, in the next couple of videos, I'll be doing, like, endgame armor and endgame setups and, you know, stuff like that. So, without that, and here's all the endgame stuff. Stardust, Vortex, Nebula, you have your solar. Yeah, that's just other stupid things that I decided to put here. And I will do weapon guides and other things like that in the next video. And I'll see you guys later.